Welcome children to our preposition video 2. Today we are going to learn preposition of direction or moment. But before that, just let's revise what we have learned in video 1. We have learned what is preposition. Preposition is a word that is often placed before a noun or a pronoun to show its relation with some other word in a sentence. For example, in, at, towards, about, etc. We had also seen there are three types of preposition which we are going to learn in this chapter: preposition of place, direction, and time. Preposition of place is also known as preposition of position, and direction can also be referred as preposition of moment. So today we are going to learn preposition of direction or movement. The preposition of direction or a moment suggests how people or things move and where they move to. Some prepositions of moment or to refer to a direction, we use prepositions like to, in, into, on, through, along, across, etc. Let's see some examples. She drove to the store. Here, to is showing the direction that she is going to that store. Don't ring the doorbell, come right into the house. Drive on to the grass and the park and park the car there. So here into and onto is also showing the preposition of direction. Another few examples. The leopard darted towards the leaping deer. We walked along the dusty path, or the earthworm crept into its hole. Now here, when you have to use in and into, I'll just tell you how to use, when to use that in and into in the later part. First, let us see use of to and at. Use to with the verbs of moment, like I go to school, drive to, come to the party, drive to the work, so on. And at, use at to suggest in the direction of or towards something. Like when you do something towards someone, like I smiled, you cannot say smile to him, you say smiled at him. I stopped at the signal, turned at the crossing. So we use, now we will see how to use across and through. Use across to show the movement from one side to the other. Just for an example, across is, suppose here is a something and you have to go here. So here is your house and suppose this is a bridge. So I ran across the bridge, or my house is across the bridge. Or when you're talking about a road, so from this part of the road to the other part, from one end to the other end. That time we use across. Now through. Through is used to show from one side to another, but it is surrounded by something. Like a pipe. If you have a something pipe like this and the rat went through the pipe. For example, while traveling on the expressway, you get tunnels. So that time we say, I went through the tunnel because it is enclosed, surrounded. Right. So the example is the coin slipped through my or the child through child's fingers. So what is the difference between cross and through? Across is just from one end to the other end, and through is also from one side to the other, but it is in enclosed. So when you read the sentences, you should know whether you have to use across or whether you have to use through. Here are some examples of pictorial presentation of preposition of direction or movement. As I told you, in and into. When to use in and when to use into. In is preposition of place, right? But into, when you are showing some movement, like here in this picture, if you see, rat is going into the box. It means it's moving inside. Another example, poor the juice in my glass. That is wrong. You cannot say pour the juice in my glass. No. You have to say pour the juice into the glass or pour the water into the glass. So when there is a movement, that time you have to use into or out of. Correct? This is the difference when how to use in and into. I hope this is clear with you all. Next session we'll meet with another video on preposition, that is preposition of time, which is going to be very interesting. Okay, children, thank you. Have a nice day.